Hey, book's coming along well. Thank you.
Oh, hey!
Kinda busy here, but I guess I can talk for a bit. What's up? It does, doesn't it? I mostly just deal with it after it's junked. But a trader gave me this bit of electronics from the ROBCO factory. If there's a way to reactivate and control the robots there, it'd make for a good example of harnessing the past technology for the book. Yeah, you should just be able to plug it into the mainframe at the ROBCO production facility. It'll give you access to the robots and terminals. Okay, here. And be sure to keep an eye peeled for any other examples of how to make old technology work for you out there. Good luck with that research.
Don't try anything.
Welcome to Megaton. Enjoy your stay.
Been rather busy lately, asking questions, investigating. So is that it? You're some kind of investigator? A detective for hire? Or do you have some kind of personal grudge against an innocent android who simply wants to be left alone? Please tell me. I'd really like to know. Well, if that's true, then the first thing you need to do is halt your investigation. No more questions. No more searching. The movement I'm involved with, we help his kind escape their Commonwealth-imposed slavery. We help them disappear. You understand? You really want help? Take this. It's an internal component from the very android you're searching for. Don't ask how I obtained it. Present it to Dr. Zimmer in Rivet City. Tell him the android is dead, and that was on the corpse. He'll believe you. Do that, and Zimmer will go back to the Commonwealth and leave that poor soul alone. Do that, and you'll have saved a man's life. We call ourselves the Railroad. Our mission is the rescue and salvation of synthetic humanoids. Androids, as they're more commonly known. Just understand that this android is now, for all intents and purposes, a man. He looks human, he acts human, he believes he is human. But even if he's not, even if he's a machine, he's capable of rational thought and emotion. So you see, his soul is as human as yours or mine. This person, and he is a person, deserves a chance at freedom. Please, if there's a shred of decency in you, don't take that away from him. Tell you what. You deliver that component to Zimmer and tell him the android is dead, and you can consider yourself a member in good standing. Yes, if we are able, but there are others in the wasteland who assist in the plight of human slaves. Our android brethren have only us. You know what you need to do. You're doing.
Hello, stranger. I'm Tinker Joe, premier supplier of robotic parts and service throughout the DC wasteland. I'm afraid these bots are all spoken for. I'm just delivering them now. I've got a custom Gutsy that isn't spoken for, but... Well, RL3's a bit finicky about the company he keeps, and I don't think he likes the look of you. Nothing personal, of course. Various things. You never know what might come in handy. Thanks. Bye.
Another glorious day in this man's army.
Remember that secret android project I told you about? Well, they got some serious pre-war tech on their hands. They nabbed a lipoplasticator and a microdermal graftalizer for the facial reconstruction. Not sure where they'll find a chopper with enough skills to use it without making him look like a freaking ghoul. Oh, and get this. Can you believe they found a circuit neuralizer? That or someone built one. Word is that they're going to completely rewire the brain of one of those things. If you know who they got working on this, let me... The guy.
together can we hope to reach our full potential. The way we were before the war. Whole, beautiful, powerful. One enclave, one America. Now.
Move along, please. This area clear. Commencing lawful use of deadly force. Move along, please.
Remember me? Tinker Joe at your service. Robots for sale, robots serviced while you wait. Interested? I'm afraid these...
Sale. I have only a demonstration model. Tinker Joe will be glad to handle any of your robotic needs. Have a nice day.
Fiddle with any interesting technology lately? Harnessing the technology of the past and modifying it for your own purposes? That's just the thing! Tell me all about how it worked out. Well, they're only human. Made by humans. Well, probably manufactured by other robots, but... You know where I'm going with this. Seems like a good thing to watch for when dealing with tech of any age. And it helps to pack a few pulse grenades, just in case. Here, have a few. Oh, and take my book on science. For some reason, I just can't get into the computer parts. But I've got the rest pretty much memorized. Yes, that concludes our exceptional expert endeavor. I have to admit, I was worried it would go over some people's heads, but it should be fine. For all your hard work, I want you to have this mini nuke. I kept meaning to use it to dig a well, but honestly, it just makes me nervous. Now, I just need to do a few last tweaks, and it'll be ready to print and distribute. Thanks for all the help. So cynical! No. I can take care of all that with the few traitors I know. What makes you think I'd force you to handle something so dangerous? Now you should just lie back and bask in the praise for helping with the book. Oh, it's great! Why, with the information here, we'll save hundreds of lives, maybe even thousands. I'll share these with the traders, and soon everyone will know about the Wasteland Survival Guide. But first, here, the very first copy of our book goes to you. I couldn't have done it without you, my Wasteland Survival Expert. Absolutely. Good hunting! Oh, hey! Kinda busy. You got caps for me? See ya.
What do you need? Well, I'll be. The pressure's up in the plant. It looks like all the leaks have been fixed. Thank you, stranger. Thank you. But listen, it's only a matter of time before they burst again. And someone like you might not be around to fix them. I'll make you a deal. I'll give you caps for any scrap metal you can bring me. You'll find it all over the place out there in the waste. If I have a steady supply of scrap, I can keep the plant running and the pipe should be just fine. We got a deal? Good! This just keeps looking better. Those parts will keep this place running and the town in fresh water. Hurry back as soon as you find some. Yeah? What is it? I sure am, Sonny. What have you got for me? Well, all right. Let me count out your caps. Well, back to work.
Can you help me? I need water. Purified water, please. Please, if you find some, please.
You can tell Tenpenny he can kiss my ass. We've got plenty of bottle caps. Let me in, goddammit.
How many times do we have to go through this? You're not getting in.
I can stand here all day yelling at you through this damn speaker if I have to.
I've already told you Tenpenny won't allow zombies to live here.
Who the hell are you calling a zombie?
You're definitely not human, that's for damn sure. For the last time, no zombies allowed.
Can't you tell the difference between me and a feral? Fine, I'll show you the goddamn difference. Just you wait. You'll get yours, all of you. Really not in the mood, so leave me alone. I'm really not in the mood, so leave.
I thought I told you to get the hell out of here. Tenpenny doesn't want your goddamn caps, and I don't want the goddamn headache. For the last time, get your rotten, ugly, goddamn ghoul ass off Mr. Tenpenny's private property. Oh. Sorry about that. I thought you were one of those damn ghouls looking for a handout. You are currently trespassing on Alistair Tenpenny's private property. Do you have some reason to be here? That's rich. What would a man like Tenpenny want to do with a waste rat like you? Just a minute. Let's not be hasty. If Tenpenny is interested in what you have to say, I suppose you should get your chance. Though he normally conducts all his business through Mr. Burke. If Tenpenny doesn't want to talk to you, then you best best leave him alone. If you bother Mr. Tenpenny or any of his residents, I will be very glad to forcibly show you out. Do we understand each other? Good.
Welcome to Tenpenny Tower. Don't do anything stupid.
Righto.
If you're listening to this recording, it is because you're believed to be trustworthy. I hope that is the case, because this recording puts us both in danger. I'm escaping from the Commonwealth. I'm an android, a synthetic man, a slave. The men hunting me are ruthless and will stop at nothing to retrieve their property. I need to find a doctor in the wasteland to perform facial reconstruction. I also need someone who knows a great deal about computers.
I can assure you, Mr. Wellington.
I need to have my memories erased and my face altered to look like someone else.
I've heard some positively awful things about...
Edgar Wellington II, have you met my wife, Millicent? Hold on, who let you in here? Very well. As long as security is aware of your presence. Can't be too careful these days. What with these ghouls and all. Gustavo says he has the situation well in order, but I wonder if he's really trying. Don't suppose you ran into any ghouls on your way in here? Then you obviously don't know anything about ghouls. There's a pack of zombies living nearby in some old tunnel. They asked to move in, naturally. They were told to go to hell. Gustavo's hired some additional goons. Seems to be working. Still makes one a bit fidgety having those loathsome creatures around. I wouldn't even want them as slaves. Well, I just remembered I have something important to do. Goodbye.
Not him. But Tenpenny trusts him. So it can't be all...
Give me a second. Keep your panties on.
Tenpenny trusts him, so it can't be all bad.
Hey there.
I'm on duty, Kent.
What? That damn Roy Phillips won't take no for an answer. Keep showing up, looking for a handout. He and his kind aren't wanted. End of story. If I were a betting man, I'd place a stack of caps on him trying something violent soon. And that would make Tenpenny nervous. I don't like it when Tenpenny gets nervous. But I can't spare the manpower to go hunt down Roy Phillips and his band of misfits, or I'd gladly end this thing once and for all. You're out of line. Those filthy bitches can stay living in those metro tunnels. They'll move in here over my dead body. Quite right. You're not such a moron after all. That's a laugh. Roy Phillips can't be reasoned with. Trust me. But go ahead and try and talk some sense into him. It's your funeral. They've holed up in the nearby metro tunnels. They're living with packs of feral ghouls. They've barred the main entrance. Go through the train yard. Good luck, kid. You're gonna need it. Watch it.
Talk. Direct your security concerns to Chief Gustavo directly.
Mr. Edgar. Mr. Wellington, are you there?
Hello.
Thank you.
You there! Put your weapons away! Come over here! No funny business, unless you want to get shot. What are you doing here? It's not safe for your kind around here. Oh yeah? Is he expecting you? Well then, run along. It's not wise to keep Roy waiting. Has a bit of a temper, that one. You watch yourself. I've been stomping around with Roy and his gang of misfits. Roy's a no-nonsense, take-no-prisoners kind of guy. He heard about this Tenpenny asshole, and now he's trying to get us in that tower. He's hatching some kind of plan to kill all those bigot bastards. Believe it or not, I used to vacation there. I wasn't always like this. I was a goddamn scientist. We were doing great things. Amazing things. Sure, sacrifices were required. Some people got hurt. But we were making real progress. But then those goddamn bombs dropped. Karma's a real bitch. You'd be wise to remember that. Go live your life, kid.
Hello. I'm Bessie Lynn. I don't think you should be down here. Did you talk to Roy? I hope you know what you're doing. You could get in a lot of trouble by coming around uninvited. I wouldn't want to see anyone get hurt. You must be pretty tough to get past all the ferals. They tend to leave us alone, but someone like you... Am I babbling again? Roy tells me I shouldn't do that. Oh, well, it's not so bad, I guess, once you get used to it. But it's not like before. I used to be pretty, you know. Everyone used to come around all the time. People stop wanting to be around you, though, when it starts to happen. When you start to change, I mean. Oh, okay then, have a nice one.
What do you want? So you killed a bunch of feral ghouls. Is that supposed to sound impressive? I got no compassion left for those mindless freaks. But they were a nice deterrent keeping out smooth-skinned bastards like yourself. Biding our time, making plans, getting ready. Tenpenny and his pack of elitist wannabes can't keep us out of that tower forever. We've got rights, and we'll take them if they aren't given to us. I already got a plan. They think I'm a monster? I'll show them the real monsters. We'll unleash our feral brethren on them. All those bigoted sons of bitches will get torn apart. Trouble is getting past the damn subway access door. You see this? Some kind of escape door that leads from the Tenpenny basement to the subway tunnels. There must be some way to get that open. Now you're talking my language. All right, here's the plan. I'll gather up a horde of ferals and wait for you by that escape door. You find a way to get it open, and then we'll sit back and enjoy the show. Try it if you like. Go talk to Tenpenny. Ask him if he wants us living there. It won't work, so when you fail, we can do it my way. What about it? You think so, do you? Give it a shot, kid. But you're dreaming. I'll wait to give you a shot, but then we're doing it my way. You better choose your next words really carefully, because you're starting to piss me off. Sure, whatever you say, you pretentious two-faced asshole. Uh-huh. Fine, whatever. Being a ghoul ain't anything worse than any other thing somebody's got to deal with. Like your stupidity, for example. You can't help it. You were born stupid, or dropped on your head as a kid. Either way, it ain't nothing you can change. So you deal with it. Hurry!
Just a moment.
Yeah, this better be important. You mean the generator room? What the hell do you need to know about that for? That area is strictly off limits. There's no secret. It's just a sensitive area we don't need idiots and assholes screwing around in. There's an emergency entrance to the tunnels, you know, for when the bombs fell. We siphon power from the metro grid to keep our generators running. But I've got better things to do than play tour guide, so unless there's some kind of emergency, this conversation's over. I've got the only key, and I ain't lending it to you. I lost it once and had to make a new one. Tenpenny practically bit my head off, so forget it. Hell no. Tenpenny won't allow it, and I take my orders from him. He'd be out of his goddamn mind. But like I said, ultimately, I work for him, so whatever he says goes. But I wouldn't like it. Look, kid, I don't care what you think about them. Unless Tenpenny says otherwise, they aren't allowed in here. End of story. Quit wasting my time. I still got... You got something to say? He owns this building. We get our caps from him. And don't you forget it.
Mr. Tenpenny isn't taking callers. Hold on there a minute. Oh, all right, I'll let you in, but if Tenpenny hollers because he isn't expecting you, you're dead.
Nice to see you. Carry on. You have a curious look about you. I presume you have something interesting to tell me. Why, I do believe you've lost your mind. Ghouls living here? You're serious? I don't suppose I'd mind terribly if ghouls were to live here. And it would be a good bit of sport hunting them down if they misbehaved. I dare say, though, you'll have a bit of trouble convincing certain residents to go along with your novel proposition. Tell you what, if you can convince Mr. and Mrs. Wellington, Mr. Ling, Ms. Montenegro, and Ms. Lancaster, those ghouls can live here. Have you seen me shoot? I'm quite proficient, if I do say so myself. You have a curious... What? That area is strictly off-limits. Can't have people fooling around with the terminal down there. They could shut off power and open the escape door. Some might say Tenpenny Tower is my crowning achievement, but no. No, no, my dear boy, it is just the beginning. Oh, it's impolite for a gentleman to talk about himself, but I'd hope this magnificent tower would speak volumes. Cheerio!
Can I help you? Mr. Tenpenny isn't taking...
I am Comrade Cheng, beloved leader of the people, shining servant of the community. How can I help you? Thanks, comrade. I'm sure you'll agree the people are only as strong as their leader. That's why I do my best to serve the community to the fullest. Speaking of service to the community, I don't suppose you are familiar with ghouls, are you? More importantly, how to kill them? I formed a committee to investigate the problem. That's wonderful, comrade! Truly wonderful! Before you go ghoul hunting, talk to Gustavo. He might be able to help you. Ghouls wouldn't make the best of neighbors, comrade. Well, perhaps you're right, comrade. Some of these folk have a few things to learn about camaraderie, that's for sure. Well, all right. I'm willing to give them a chance. All right, comrade. We'll welcome them into the community. Yeah, see you.
Can I help you?
Yes?
TENPENNY Tower is a wonderful place to live, isn't it? We are safe from the wasteland in here.
I'm off duty. Come back when... what the hell? Let's just get it over with. I'm Dr. Banfield. What do you need? I heard old Pinkerton at Rivet City had a lipoplasticator and microdermal graftalizer. I'd be lying if I said I wasn't jealous. I'm not sure. My first responsibility is the health and welfare of the residents of TENPENNY Tower. Ghouls often carry diseases due to radiation, damaging their immune systems. Well, if they don't mind me giving them a thorough exam, and if they agree to follow any directives I give them regarding health and hygiene, I suppose I wouldn't mind too terribly. It'd give me a chance to study ghoul physiology. Sure, no problem. Remember, just say no to drugs, unless I prescribe them.
Well, well, what have we here? Allow me to introduce myself. I'm Susan Lancaster. Perhaps we can become better acquainted in the near future. Me too. Especially rich, fine young men. Listen, you look like you can handle yourself. You survived out there in the wasteland getting here, after all. You ever have to deal with ghouls? Fine, never mind. I thought you were a real man. Turns out you're just a scared little boy. Are you going to do something about the problem or not? I've come too far to share my digs with some droopy ghoul. Well, if you don't mind their stink, then you should go squat with them in their dirty tunnels and leave us civilized people alone. I've hung with tougher assholes than you. I can handle myself. I'm not afraid of you. Besides, I'm one of TENPENNY's favorites. There's no way they'd agree to letting ghouls live here. We all came here to get away from things like ghouls and disease and all that ugliness. I'm really tired of you and your ghoul crusade. Why do you keep bothering me? Yeah, supposedly there's some kind of emergency access to the metro tunnels. It'd have to be a pretty big emergency to get me down there, that's for sure. There's all kinds of gross things that live in those tunnels. Talk to Chief Gustavo if you want to know more. I think he's the only one that has a key. Sure, see ya.
Hi, you're new around here. I'm Margaret Primrose. I run the Café Beau Monde. Stop by sometime. I've heard they carry diseases. I'd have to sanitize everything after them all the time. Besides, they are dangerous, aren't they? I don't know. As long as they don't cause trouble, they'd have to try to fit in with our established community. I guess I'd be willing to give it a try. I guess so, sure. Have a good one.
Hey there. Is there some... There's no... Beats living out there in the wasteland, trust me. See, I'm not like these other puffed-up fogies. I earned my way into privilege. I worked to get here. Sure, see ya.
more things.
Welcome to Boutique La Chic. I'm Lydia Montenegro, proprietor. Here you'll find only the best, with a price tag you can boast about to your friends. Your taste in shopping venue is impeccable. How may I assist you? You're being serious? That's out of the question. What an absurd notion. I think you must have been out in the sun too long. Perhaps I could sell you a nice hat to keep your brain from frying. You horrible little zombie lover. What right do you and your disgusting buddies have to push honest, hardworking, important people around like that? Where do you propose I live? Don't worry. Did you just step out of a vault? Haven't you seen what's out there? I'm doomed. And it's all your fault.
I'm quite well, thank you. Where'd you...
Early to bed, early to rise.
Hey.
Morning.
Good to see you again, Com.
Hey there. Is there something I can do for you? Why do you... Beats living up. Yeah, goodbye.
Yes?
Welcome to TENPENNY Tower.
This better be important.
I would surely have perished if it wasn't for Mr. TENPENNY and his tower.
Welcome to new urban apparel. I carry the finest in pre-war clothes. Hurry up, let's get you out of those old rags and into something fabulous. With my fashion sense and your bottle caps, there is no limit to what we can do for your image. I can't wait to get started. You can't be serious. Ghouls aren't human. They live in filth. They eat their own babies. You're out of your right freaking mind. Why would you hang out with dirty vermin like that? You enjoy sifting through feces? You know, it's only a matter of time before they get hungry and eat you. You're crazy. Ghouls will never live in TENPENNY Tower. In case you haven't noticed, I run a fabulous shop and live in the most fabulous of places. You can't push people like me around. Ha! If my neighbors lose their minds and agree to such a thing, then I hope security shoots them in the head with their zombie friends. They were told they can't live here, but those zombies are too stupid to understand. They live in their own filth, squatting in the nearby metro tunnel. Security keeps shooting them, but they keep coming back. It's not happening. Mm-hmm.
Hey there.
Don't even think of breaking into that.
I'd be
better if I could get my hands on some caviar. But what can you do? Charmed, I'm sure. How are you?
Splendid. Simply splendid. Thanks so much for asking.
Mr. Tenpenny isn't...
You have a curious look about you. I presume you have something interesting to tell me. Cheerio.
Well, kid, what have you accomplished? Well, get going then. Open the door. What's taking you so damn long? Hurry up. Hurry up. Those bigots got big comeuppance waiting for them.
Watch it.
Give me a second. Keep your panties on.
Hello. What's the matter, huh?
I'm not here for your entertainment.
Morning.
TENPENNY Tower is a wonderful place. Ah, hello.
Watch your manners.
And how are you this fine day? TENPENNY Tower is a wonderful place to live, isn't it?
You have a curious...
this is hopeless! I'm out of here!
job, kid. Meet me around front. I have something for you to keep the ferals from gnawing on your ass. Great job, kid. Here, take this mask. It'll keep you safe from the ferals. Just don't get too close to them, or they'll sniff you out. Don't forget to put it on!